think one of the reasons why people get confused with RootMotion is that there are so many options. So I visualized it, and once you see the difference by putting them side by side, even if you don't understand fully, you sort of get the intuitive visualization in your head that will help you choose which option to pick for your own game. Not only are we concerned about the RootMotion checkbox itself, we should also be looking at the individual animation options. There's probably more than 20 different variations you can come up with, but to help you understand better, I've simplified it down to only horizontal rotation and movement, so we're not concerned about Y position in this video, but the basic principle is the same, and you can apply the exact same idea to Y position as well. I'm also using the same type of settings for rotation and position, but you can use them to create different variations. I have 8 major variations in this scene, but note that you can have more. Now let's talk about the important details. You might notice that once you have Bake into Pose checked, it doesn't matter whether you have RootMotion on or off. Once you have Bake into Pose, what's important is this option, Original or Body Orientation. Unity has a way to calculate center mass rotation and position, so as you can see, the original animation is that the body is facing this way, while the character is walking this way. This is the original animation, hence the name original. It's pretty straightforward. In this option, we don't really care about center mass, we just care about how the original animation is set up. What's peculiar is the other option, body orientation. Here we're getting the center mass orientation, and then using that as a basis for the animation. The first frame will always have the center mass facing forward, so the animation will be rotated to fit that direction. Now let's talk about non-baked. This is where RootMotion comes in. The same concept applies to the original versus center mass orientation, but depending on whether you have RootMotion checked or not, the transform position of the game object may or may not take into account the root transform data of the animation. In other words, with the RootMotion checked, whatever positional or rotational data is in the animation, that will be applied to the game object. On the other hand, if you uncheck RootMotion, the root transform data of the animation will be ignored. Most animations in Mixamo.com have this root transform data, so you can use RootMotion to have the animation change transform position of its game object. Here is another example. This time, the original animation is that the character is moving to the side in a 90-degree angle. With the original option, we don't really care about the center mass. We only care about the original animation, which is moving straight to the side. With the body orientation option, first we align the character to the direction of the center mass, and then rotate the animation to face that direction. To show you a simplified version of RootMotion, I made another scene with just the cube. I recorded an animation where there's two types of data, one is changing scale, the other is changing position. Keyframe 1 is default, position is 0, and scale is 1. Keyframe 2 is where we change position Z to 2 and change up the scale. Keyframe 3 is the same as frame 1 in terms of scale, but position Z is 4. This positional change in Z is the root transform data. Without RootMotion, the object will play a loop going from keyframe 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and back to 1. With RootMotion, now the positional change is relative. Starting from where you are, you move 2z ahead on keyframe 2, and on keyframe 3, 4z ahead. So every time the animation is played, you're moving 4z ahead. Simply by understanding root transform, the bake option, as well as how center mass is taken into account, you should now have a much better understanding on how RootMotion works. Every game is different and every animation is set up different, so I think it's nice to have many options in terms of importing an animation. But all these options, baked, original, body, and root motion, can get confusing. If you don't understand, it's important that you run an isolated test like this and really see the difference with your own eyes. You can download this project, all links are below. If you have any questions or comments, you can also reach me on my Discord server. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.